testing for night drive. Okay, so I'm currently shooting in the GoPro Hero 7 Black. Yeah, this is my first time trying it at night. I'm gonna take it out for a spin. Relatively, it's just trying to see is the mount, whether the mount is it works or not. And let's hope so. And it was just now was slight drizzle, so I apologize if the windshield is not that nice to look at. Okay, we hit after working hours right now. So everybody is rushing back to home in Malaysia. Okay. Currently, I'm driving a Perodua Myvi 1.3. This is the first gen, so it's quite a good city car. But to say a really good run around, yeah, do quite pretty well. But the fuel consumption is getting a bit worse as it's aging. Actually, my car also need to do some service soon. Going to need to change the tires and suspension as well. Mountings and absorbers are already giving a lot of terrible sounds. Basically, we are going to head over to Jalan Klang Lama just for a test run on the GoPro Hero 7. Well, somehow tonight was raining, drizzling a bit, so I apologize if the windshield is not quite good for the video. Basically, Malaysia is quite, I would say, driving in Malaysia is still quite enjoyable. Yes, occasionally the jams are quite hectic for no reason. Every day you can, maybe you're going back to work, even after working hours, the jams are crazy, crazy enough. Well, sometimes it just needs to take like 2 hours to go back to your home, minimum. I think most Klang Valley people will understand the pain. Jams in the KL and Selangor area. Okay. by the way, I'm currently using the Continental CC5. Yeah, the tire is also almost due by this year. I'm going to need to change the tire soon as well. Thinking of upgrading to a 15-inch on this Myvi, but not sure. Do you think should I change it? Tire was a bit still a good car to run around in the city area, but if you want to have a nice car for highways, built for speed, I would say no, this car is not the car for you to speed up. With the drizzle today, so the viewing might not be so nice today. basically the aircon is still working quite well on my car. Yeah, what else more in this car? Well, basically, it's quite the usual, the basics. Nothing much, honestly. Although this is a Easy Eye edition, which means it's equipped with the ABS as well. Nowadays are equipped with much more better equipments. That is for sure. There's much more better infotainment than last time cars are being manufactured. So for those people who love infotainments, I would say you don't grab all these second hand Myvis. Maybe if you want to grab, try to get those as like already upgraded version. Because Myvi is, I would have to say, is seriously is just plain drive from point A to point B. That's it. You don't ask for more. traffic jam. We are jamming for no purposes. But not moving. That's the fun part about driving in Malaysia. We are creating a jam by ourselves. Well, look at that bus. It's just not turning, it just went straight. Woo. You can feel it as like it's retarding the car a bit at times. You can see the RPM even sometimes. I'm like giving a bit like 30-50% of throttle on the car. It's felt like it doesn't want to go, it just want to be like Hold on. No. No peak power for you. It's quite difficult, you know. At times, especially when you're trying to like chase up to pick up another vehicle. It's because it's like it's retarding the gearing a bit, and it affects a bit on the acceleration as well. But I believe on the newer version of the Myvis, it doesn't have this kind of problem as well. Well, lucky for the new models. Anyway, it's end of the test video and also my first vlogging, because I'm almost reaching home. Well, stay tuned, because I might be getting some test car to drive around as well. I'm going to review some test car as well. So stay tuned.